Hello dear students, so we are back with another session of chemistry, organic chemistry, and today we are going to continue with our alcohols, phenols and ethers topic. And in this series I am going to take now the preparation of alcohols. There are five methods to prepare alcohols. Let us see them one by one. So our topic is preparation of alcohols. Preparation of alcohols. Let us see them one by one. So the first method will be basically from to prepare alcohols from alkyl halides or haloalkanes. So I will say from haloalkanes. Now in this we will go, topic by topic. That is, first we'll complete alcohols, then phenols, and then ethers. So that's why we are starting with preparation of alcohols. So from haloalkanes, so what we are going to do here is we are going to do the hydrolysis of haloalkanes. I mean by hydrolysis of haloalkanes. So haloalkane, you know, is basically your RX group, RX compound. X is a halogen here, it may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. So in this, if you add any aqueous KOH or aqueous NaOH or moist AgOH or moist Ag2O, that is your potassium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, aqueous or moist silver hydroxide or silver oxide. If any of this you add, then you are going to get a alcohol. For example, suppose you are having CH3CH2Br. This is your bromoethane. In bromoethane, if you add any of these reagents, you are going to get CH3CH2OH. That is your ethanol. This is your bromoethane and this is your ethanol. Similarly, suppose you are having iodomethane. This is your iodomethane. In this, if you add any of this, let us say you have added moist AgOH, you have added moist silver hydroxide, then you will get CH3OH, which is your methanol. This reaction you have already seen in haloalkanes. There it came as the reactions of haloalkanes. So this reaction basically may proceed by SN1, that is substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction, or by SN2, substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction. For example, let me give you the cases one by one. For example, suppose you are having this haloalkane and this you have treated with aqueous KOH. Now what will happen here is basically this OH minus ion, this is a nucleophile. Basically OH minus ion is a nucleophile, and here carbocation will be formed because this ionization of bromine will happen in this solution. So carbocation will be formed here, and as soon as the carbocation is formed, this will be your Br minus will become the leaving group, and this carbocation will go and attach with this. So basically you will get what type of alcohol? That is again your tertiary alcohol, because this OH is attached to this carbon. Now this is your 3-degree carbocation. So you know that as far as stability of carbocation is concerned, 3-degree carbocation is more stable than 2-degree, which is more stable than 1-degree. So this is your SN1 reaction, and this is basically your racemic mixture, because here retention plus inversion both will take place. The attack may be there from the front side as well as from the back side. So this is as far as 3-degree carbocation is concerned. So this is basically an example of your SN1 mechanism. Is a two-step mechanism. First is the formation of carbocation, slow step, rate determining step, and the moment carbocation is formed, it will, being it a very stable carbocation, it will immediately attack on this OH minus nucleophile, and That is how you will get this nucleophilic substitution unimolecular reaction. I can give you an example of SN2 also. So if you know that basically, suppose you are having CH3Cl plus same aqueous KOH. Now here OH minus ion would be a nucleophile and it will attack on this carbon and the Cl would be a leaving group. Now this is a concerted mechanism. Concerted mechanism means one step reaction. Both the bond formation and the bond cleavage will happen simultaneously in one step. Transition step will be there, no intermediate will be formed, and the product would be CH3OH, which is basically your methanol. And this is your SN2 mechanism. This is SN2 mechanism. Why? Because this is a, basically it's a 1 degree carbocation. This, if you see here carefully, it's a 1 degree carbocation. So you know that in 1 degree carbocation, stability is less. So that is basically will undergo SN2. So that are the examples of your haloalkanes. Based on that you can see which particular mechanism will be there. And here you know the product would be a inversion product because the attack is always from the back side. If it is too bulky, then steric hindrance will be there and the OH minus ion will not be able to attack. Similarly, if your nucleophile is also very bulky, then one more product may be formed, which is basically your elimination product, and then that may lead to the formation of alkene. Let me give you an example. Suppose you are having this. Bromoethane, CH3CH2Br, bromoethane. Suppose you are having this, and this instead of aqueous KOH, you have taken alcoholic KOH and heat. Then what will happen is this OH minus ion, because see, if you see this carbon, would be alpha carbon and this carbon would be a beta carbon. Already I told you in my previous lecture, those students, those who are not understanding SN1, SN2 and this elimination, they need to focus my videos of nucleophilic substitution and elimination reactions. You can go to the previous videos of haloalkanes, there all the explanations is given in depth. So what will happen here is that this OH minus ion would attack on this hydrogen of the beta carbon. This hydrogen will go, the bond will come here, and this bromine would be the leaving group. So that will basically form your, potassium, KBr will be formed here. So the product would become CH2, double bond CH2, and that is your alkene. That's the reason that this particular method from haloalkanes is not very useful method to prepare alcohols, because there may be a formation of alkenes also. So, but anyways, you are getting your alcohols. So that is your method number one. So method number one is very simple. From haloalkanes, you can prepare alcohols very easily. And the reagents are aqueous potassium hydroxide, aqueous sodium hydroxide, moist silver hydroxide and moist silver oxide. Accordingly, if it is a 3 degree carbocation, then go with SN1. If it is 1 degree carbocation, then go with SN2 mechanism. And basically you need to replace the bromine and chlorine with particular OH groups. That is the thing. And there may be a basically formation of alkene also. That depends on what type of reagent you are having. Suppose the reagent is very bulky, then the bulky reagent, how it will go and attack on the carbocation or that carbon? So basically it will detach the hydrogen. And many cases I have taken in the haloalkanes also, in nucleophilic substitution reaction. That is as far as method one is concerned. You can note it down. I hope the method is very simple and clear. Let me move to method number two. You can note it down. Okay, so let us move to method number two. That is your preparation of alcohols. Second method. So this time we will get the alcohols from alkenes. Earlier already we have prepared from haloalkanes. Now we are going to prepare from alkenes. So in this also basically there are three methods. Your method number one is acid catalyzed hydration. Method number two will be your hydroboration oxidation. And method number 3, all the methods are basically preparation of alcohols from alkenes, will be oxymercuration and demercuration. From alkenes we can get alcohols by 3 methods. One is acid catalyzed hydration, hydroboration oxidation, and oxymercuration demercuration. Now let us see one by one. Let us say this is your alkene, CH2 double bond CH2. Suppose you want to add water, let us say add water. First we will go with this method, acid catalyzed hydration. Our first method is acid catalyzed hydration. Acid catalyzed hydration. Now let's try to understand. Suppose you are having like this CH2 double bond, alkene is there, ethene, you have added water. Now water is basically a source of your nucleophile, because there will be H plus and OH minus. But this double bond is also having what? Double bond is also basically a source of your electrons, and a source of electrons means what? Nucleophiles. Yes or no? So this reaction would not happen so easily. I mean, how a nucleophile can go and attack on a nucleophile? So this reaction would not happen so easily. So we need to bring some catalysis in this reaction so that the reaction may be favored. Because if my reaction may go like this, CH2, here hydrogen may be attached and here OH may be attached. But directly if you are adding water, it will not happen. So we need to bring some catalysis or catalyzer to, catalyst to undergo this reaction. So that's why we are calling it as acid catalyzed hydration. Now let us see this reaction. Suppose we are having the same compound, ethene is there, because we have to prepare it from alkenes. CH2 double bond CH2 is there. In this we have added a source of H plus. Let us say that is from concentrated H2SO4. From where we are getting a source of H plus? Concentrated H2SO4. So what will happen here is that basically this shifting of electrons will be there, polarization will be there. So let us say this will become del plus and this will become del minus. So we will get CH2, here hydrogen is there and here a carbocation is formed, positive charge is there. And this, if you are treating with H2O, so the OH will come and attack on this. So you will get something like this, CH2, this is your CH3 and here OH. So this is your reaction. You want to see one more example? Let me take one more example here. Let us say you are having CH3CH double bond CH2. So here if you see carefully, then again the shifting will happen here, because that is a plus I group, methyl is a plus I group, and plus I means what? Electron pumping. It will try to donate the electrons, because this is the electron pumping group. It will show plus I effect. Plus I effect means positive inductive effect, electron donating effect. So here the shifting will take place, and here basically you are del minus and del plus. So the formation of carbocation is there. So let me write some important points about this reaction. That is, here carbocation is formed. Carbocation is formed, and whenever carbocation is formed, it means we have to check the stability of carbocation, because there is a 3-degree carbocation is more stable than 1-degree carbocation, which is more stable than 3-degree more than 2-degree more than 1-degree carbocation. This is the stability of carbocations. And rearrangement may be there. There may be a rearrangement. Any of your shifting may be there, hydride shift or phenyl shift or methyl shift is there. Rearrangement, that is H minus may shift, CH3 minus may shift, or phenyl shifting may be there. Why? This is known as hydride shift. Why? So that stability of carbocation is maximized. I'll take some examples. Try to understand here. So in this, what we have done is a source of H plus we have added, which is from concentrated H2SO4. That is why I am calling it as acid catalyzed hydration. acid catalyzed hydration. Simply adding water, you will not get that catalysis to form this carbocation. So when this comes here, a carbocation is formed. So this is your basically this carbocation. If you see carefully, this is shown here. This H plus will go and attack on this because this is a negative charge. It will come CH3 and plus charge will be here. So this carbon is attached to two carbons. So this is a 2-degree carbocation, which is stable carbocation. There is no scope of any shifting. And this may react with H2O. Hydrolysis may be done. Hydrolysis may be done with H2O. And the OH minus ion will come and attack here. So we'll get CH3OH. Now if you see carefully, this reminds you of something. The OH and H, basically two attachments are there. One is of OH and one is of H. The OH is coming and attaching here and hydrogen is attaching here. It means that hydrogen is going to that carbon of the double bond which is already having more number of hydrogens, or the positive part is going to that carbon of the double bond which is having more number of hydrogens. It means what rule it is? Markovnikov's rule. So this addition is as far as Markovnikov's addition. Markovnikov's addition. So important points to be noted down here is that carbocation is formed, rearrangement may be possible. Suppose if there is a scope of 3-degree carbocation, then any of the shiftings may happen to for the formation of the 3-degree carbocation. And point number 3 is that here Markovnikov's addition is happening. That is what we observe here. So let us do one thing. Let me show you the mechanism of this reaction now. Exact what is the mechanism? Why we are calling it hydration? Because we are adding a molecule of water. Because we are adding a molecule of water. Whenever we are adding a molecule of water, we call it hydration. And why we are calling it acid catalyzed? Because in the beginning we need a source of acid, which is your H plus, and that is obtained from concentrated H2SO4. So note it down, and then I will show you the mechanism of this reaction. So let us see the mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration. So we are seeing the mechanism. Reaction was very simple. Reaction, once again I will show you. Suppose this was your reaction, CH3 CH double bond CH2. This is your alkene. What we are doing, we are preparing alcohols from alkenes, and in this you add H plus. So basically there will be a formation of carbocation here, plus minus. This hydrogen will come and attack on this. We get CH3 here plus, and when we treat it with water, the OH minus will come and attack here based on the stability of carbocation and the Markovnikov's addition. So this OH is attached to a carbon which is attached to two carbons. So this is a 2-degree alcohol. Now let us see the mechanism of this reaction, what we are doing. Step one would be basically, if you see carefully, this is your CH3CH double bond CH2, and this is being reacted with H2SO4, concentrated H2SO4. Now concentrated H2SO4, if you see H2SO4, concentrated H2SO4 will basically break like this, 2H plus plus SO4 2 minus. So it is a source of H plus. Concentrated H2SO4 will break like this, H plus and SO4 2 minus. So it's a source of H plus. Now step one would be attack of this electrophile, because this is what? Deficiency of electrons. That's why positive charge is there. Attack of the electrophile on the carbon atom leading to the formation of carbocation. So attack of H plus electrophile. Step one is attack of H plus electrophile on carbon atom, to form a carbocation. Once again, attack of H plus ion on carbon atom to form a carbocation, obviously stable carbocation. So what will happen here is that this shifting of electrons will be there because of this plus I effect, and here a carbocation may be formed, CH3 CH plus, and that H plus will basically attack on this minus sign. CH3. So I hope step one is clear. So after step one, we got this compound, carbocation. So carbocation is formed. And this carbocation, dear students, you know, is a 2-degree carbocation. Now let us see step two. Now in step two, what will happen here is basically the nucleophile, because you are adding water. In step two, you are adding water. So this is your CH3 here plus. You are adding water, and what is water? This is water, H2O. Water will act as a source of nucleophile. And this water molecule, these lone pairs, will go and attack on this carbon, because these electrons would need a what? Positive charge. So step two I am writing is nothing but step two is, I mean, attack of H2O nucleophile. Attack of H2O nucleophile on carbocation. And what it will form? Basically, when this attacks here, the formation of alcohol will be there, but it will be a protonated alcohol. I mean, this is attacking there. OH. H2O has attacked here. Okay. So I am saying attack of H2 nucleophile on carbocation to form a protonated alcohol. Now let us see step number three. Now in step three, what will happen is, again we will add H2O. Because here more H2O is added. Again this H2O is there. So this H2O will basically take up this H plus ion, forming hydronium ion, H3O plus ion, and what you are going to get is the alcohol, CH3CH CH3OH. So step number three will be, I can say, loss of proton forming alcohol and hydronium ion. Once again, observe step number three. This was your protonated alcohol, and in step three, H2O again will attack on this hydrogen to form your alcohol. And here H3O plus will be formed, which is your hydronium ion, and alcohol will be formed. So the final product would be CH3CH CH3OH, which is your 2-degree alcohol. Now if you see carefully, if you want to apply Markovnikov's addition, that is also fine. So H plus and OH minus. So H plus is, comes and attacks on that carbon, which is basically you are having more number of hydrogens, and OH minus basically on the other carbon, and that is what is the product we are getting. So that was your mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration, and hydration means basically adding a molecule of water. So step number one is the formation of your proton or your H plus ion, which is a electrophile, and this electrophile will attack on the carbon, forming a carbocation. As soon as carbocation is formed, the nucleophile, H2 is a nucleophile acting as a source of nucleophile, will attack on this carbon to form a protonated alcohol, and the one more molecule of H2O will basically attack on this hydrogen to form hydronium ion, H3O plus ion. This is your H3O plus ion, hydronium ion, and your alcohol is formed. So that is what is this mechanism all about. So let me do one thing. Let me take one or two examples, I mean, to tackle such type of problems. I hope the mechanism is very much clear to you. That was the first method to prepare alcohols from alkenes. Already we have seen before this, to prepare alcohols from haloalkenes, and there the reagents we have used, and here we are using concentrated H2SO4 and then a molecule of water. So note it down, and then I am going to take one or two problems. Okay, so let us take up this problem. This is your alkene. In that you are adding H2SO4 concentrated in H2. So obviously I hope you are understanding what type of reaction it is, acid catalyzed hydration. How to form your alcohol? Suppose some student is doing like this, he is trying to apply Markovnikov's, and as per Markovnikov's, your H plus and OH minus. So H plus will come and attack on this carbon, because it is having more number of hydrogens. So the product formed would be CH3CH CH3CH OH CH3. This is what many of you might do, simply adding Markovnikov's. But if we go by mechanism, then let us see what will happen is. So if we go by mechanism. So in the beginning, you know what will happen is the formation of carbocation will be there. So this will shift here. Here a negative charge will come and here a positive charge will come. So from there, what we can write is like this. CH3CH. And here hydrogen will come because that is a negative. So CH3 will come here and here plus charge. Now this hydrogen is there. If you see carefully, this hydrogen is here. If this hydrogen shifts here, then the positive charge will come here. And if the positive charge comes here, then this carbon is attached to first carbon, second carbon, third carbon. Suppose the methyl comes here, then here you will get a positive charge. Then this positive charge means this carbon is attached to this carbon and this carbon. So here hydride shift will be there. Yes or no? Hydride shift will be there. Why? Observe here. Why? CH3C. Suppose this hydrogen shifts here like this. Then the positive charge will come on this carbon. And here what you are having is CH2CH3. Now you see here, see this carbon. On this a positive charge is there. And attached to this carbon, 1 carbon, 2 carbon, 3 carbon. So this is a 3-degree carbocation. And you know stability of carbocation. 3 degree is more stable than 2 degree. In your earlier case, only 2-degree carbocation was formed. So I will attach OH here because this is a more stable carbocation. So CH3 CH3 OH CH2 CH3. That is my final product, and this is the correct answer and this is the incorrect answer. So every time you should not attach as far as Markovnikov's addition. Yes, what you have to see here is basically your stability of carbocation, and because here rearrangement may be possible, so the carbocation will always want to become the most stable carbocation. So accordingly, hydride shift may be there, methyl shift. We have to check which shift will help us better. Here we could have shifted methyl also, but when we shift methyl here, again this would become a 2 degree carbocation only. That's why I have shifted a 3 degree. I have shifted hydride so that we are forming a 3 degree carbocation. I hope this example is very much clear to you, and accordingly you have to do it. As far as this question is concerned, I hope it is clear. And let me move to the another methods of formation of alcohols from alkenes. So note it down. Okay, dear students, so let us continue with the second method of preparation of alcohols, and we are preparing it from alkenes. In that already I have taken one method, which is basically your acid catalyzed hydration. Now I am taking second method, which is your hydroboration oxidation. The name itself suggests the type of method. First we have to do hydroboration and subsequently oxidation. So first let me show you what is the reaction, and then we'll see the mechanism of the reaction. So your reaction is this. Suppose you are having alkene CH3CH double bond CH2. This is your propene. This is reacted with borane in presence of THF. And after hydroboration, basically this is known as hydroboration, and then we have to do oxidation in presence of hydrogen peroxide, that is H2O2, and your alkaline medium, you can say OH-. Basically what you are going to get is CH3 CH2 CH2 OH. You will get basically 3 moles of this, because here we have to again use 3 moles of this, and plus H3BO3, boric acid you are going to get. So from alkene you are going to get alcohol. So this is the reaction basically. Your alkene, first you have to do hydroboration, BH3 in presence of THF, and then we will do its oxidation in presence of alkaline medium and H2O2, and we will get a alcohol as well as boric acid. So let us do one thing. Let us see the mechanism of this reaction. First, let us see the step of hydroboration. So what we are using is BH3. So this BH3 has come from B2H6. B2H6 is diborane. BH3. This will give 2BH3, which is your borane. It's an important inorganic compound. Particularly, you know that as a boron is a group 13 element, and BH3 is basically, if you see carefully its structure, electronic structure, then it's a incomplete octet. This is incomplete octet. So I can say that this is, because you observe here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electrons are there. So it is incomplete octet. It means what? It means that this is an electron deficient molecule. Electron deficient molecule. So it will need electrons. That electrons will be basically supplied from this alkene. So it's electron deficient molecule. So I hope you are clear with BH3. BH3 is this electron deficient molecule because of incomplete octet. Totally 8 electrons should have been there, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only 6 electrons are there. And THF. What is THF? THF is tetrahydrofuran. Tetrahydrofuran. Basically, it's a ether only. This is your THF. So what THF will do is it will keep the borane busy. Basically, it will form a complex with borane like this. Observe here. This is your THF and this is your BH3. So there will be a lone pair of electrons here, and this lone pair of electrons will form a complex with BH3. So basically, you will have a complex compound like this. So that, because BH3 is electron deficient molecule, it will be in search of your electrons. So it may go and polymerize, and we need to stop that. So that is why what we are doing is, for some time we are keeping this complex so that BH3 is busy with this THF. That is the only reason to add THF. Now let us see what will actually happen in the mechanism. Let us see the mechanism of this reaction. Mechanism. Step 1. In step 1, what will happen is, this alkene is there. CH3CH double bond CH2. This will react with BH3. How? BH3 is the electron deficient molecule. It wants electrons. So these electrons of this pi bond is there. So basically what can happen is, because this is a plus I effect, it will show the plus I effect, electron pumping effect. So the shifting of electrons will be there, and here a small negative charge will come, and here a small positive charge will come, and BH3 will basically attack on this because it is in need of electrons. So you will get a complex like this, CH3, CH, CH2, B, H, 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 and a small negative charge will come, and here a small positive charge is there. Once again, try to understand, BH3 is electron deficient molecule. The pi electron shifting will be there because of the plus I effect, and here a small negative charge, this is small positive charge. This negative charge may be attracting this BH3 because it is in need of electrons, as BH3 is an electron deficient molecule. This type of structure will be formed, and this carbon positive, this positive charge of the carbon will be attracted to this hydrogen, and you will get a cyclic transition state. Cyclic transition state. You will get a cyclic transition state. Now once this cyclic transition state is obtained, from here what you are going to get is this CH3. This hydrogen will be attached to this CH3CH2 and CH2BH2. This is what is the compound you will get. Now in this, what we have to do is basically to observe from here is that BH3 is there, in that one hydrogen has attacked on this carbon or is attached to this carbon, and BH2 is attached here. Now we need to have one more molecule of this alkene, and let us take one more molecule of the alkene, CH3CH double bond CH2. Now here also the same thing will happen. What happened in the step 1? In step 1, if you see carefully, from BH3 one hydrogen is attached on this carbon and BH2 is attached here. So in step 2 also the same thing will happen. Basically I can say that this is my R. So this entire, this hydrogen will come and attach here, and this entire compound will come and attach here. So you will get a compound like this, CH3 CH2 CH2, and to this what will be attached is BH CH3 CH2 CH2. Yes or no? CH3 CH2 CH2 BH, same thing will happen. Acha, this can I write like this? This entire thing I can write like this. This is, let us say this is R, so this is also R, so I can write like this, R2 BH R2 BH R2 BH. Now here one more molecule of the alkene will be reacting, and then you will get R3B. This is step number 1, R3B. What is R3B? R3B is this CH3 CH2 CH2 thrice B. So this is as far as hydroboration is concerned. So step 1 is over. Now let us move to step 2. So I think you already noted it down. I'll just rub it out and I'll show you what is step 2. Okay, let us see step 2. Step 1 is very much simple. Once again, electron deficient molecule, the electron shifting will be there because of plus I effect, electron donating effect. So here negative charge, positive charge, this negative charge will go and attract this BH3. So that is what is there. This carbon positive will attract this hydrogen because of the positive charge, and what will happen here is a force centered cyclic transition state will be formed, and that may lead to like this CH3 CH2 CH2 BH2. Again one more molecule of alkene will come. Again the same thing will happen, one hydrogen will come and attack here, and the remaining compound will be attached here. And once again, so three molecules we have used here. As the next step, which is your oxidation step, this was your step number 1, hydroboration. Now let us see second step, oxidation step. Now here what will happen here is your R3B, which is this CH3 CH2 CH2 thrice B. This we have to do hydrolysis, we have to do the oxidation of this in presence of an alkaline medium. So OH minus will go and attack here, so you will get CH3 CH2 CH2 OH thrice plus H3 BO3. So this is your final product. If you see carefully, then first step is your hydroboration, second step is your oxidation. That's why the name of the process itself is hydroboration oxidation. Another thing what to note down here is that, some important points to note down here is, if you see carefully, the OH is attached here and hydrogen has come here. If hydrogen comes here and OH comes here, that would have been Markovnikov's, because Markovnikov's rule says that hydrogen will go and attach on that carbon which is already having more number of hydrogens. So it is having more number of hydrogens. But here what is attached? OH is attached, and here hydrogen. I mean, this is basically as per anti-Markovnikov's addition. So here I can write anti-Markovnikov's addition is there. That is point number 1. And point number 2 here is that here there is a addition is in cis, or I can say syn. Addition is in cis or syn manner. This point I will clear in questions. So I hope it is very much clear to you. We got alcohols from alkene using hydroboration and then oxidation, and the mechanism is very much clear, and the product formed as per anti-Markovnikov's addition. In the previous case, that is your acid catalyzed hydration, There it was basically we were adding a molecule of water, but how we were adding it as per Markovnikov's addition, but keeping the stability of carbocation in intact. So this is as far as this method is concerned. So let us do one thing, let us move to method number 3, and after method 3 we will take up some questions.
Note it down.
So we are back with the third method from alkenes, and it is known as oxymercuration, demercuration. Oxymercuration, demercuration. So let us see the reaction. Suppose we are having CH3CH double bond CH2. In this we are using mercuric acetate, means our reagent is, mercuric acetate, which is basically this CH3COO twice Hg, CH3COO twice Hg, this one CH3C double bond O Hg O C double bond O CH3, this is mercuric acetate, CH3CH double bond CH2. Now what I can do here is we need to add this OAC twice Hg. This is acetate, this one OAC twice Hg in presence of THF, and then we have to do its reduction, LiAlH4, or you can also use NaBH4 as reducing agents. The product would be this. I'm writing here CH3CH CH3OH. So this is as per, if you see here carefully, this is as per your Markovnikov's addition. This is as per Markovnikov's addition. Your previous method, hydroboration oxidation, that was as per anti-Markovnikov's. This addition is as per Markovnikov's addition, leading the formation of your alcohol. Here mechanism is not important. For hydroboration and oxidation, already I have shown you the mechanism. So basically, to give you a list, from alkenes, there are three methods. First is your acid catalyzed hydration. That is in presence of H2SO4. The source of H2SO4 can be concentrated H2SO4 and your H2O. So basically what you have to remember here is that you will get your product as per stability of carbocation. Rearrangement may be there. Rearrangement is possible, and this was, most of the products are following here Markovnikov's addition. In second method, which is your hydroboration oxidation, if you see the reagent, that was your BH3 in presence of THF, tetrahydrofuran. That was making a complex with BH3, because BH3 is electron deficient, it should not polymerize, dimerize or polymerize, so that it is it can be used as a reactant with alkene, and it was followed by your H2O2 in presence of an alkaline medium, oxidation of using H2O2 peroxide in presence of an alkaline medium, and you are getting your product as per Markovnikov's addition. And your third is your oxymercuration demercuration, and here your reactants were OAC twice Hg in presence of THF, followed by your reduction using NaBH4 or LiAlH4 also you can use. And here the product was, here it was anti-Markovnikov's, here it is Markovnikov's. Just correct here. Here it was anti-Markovnikov's. So this is as far as preparation from alkenes is concerned. And before this, we have already seen preparation from halo alkenes. There we have used aqueous KOH, aqueous AgOH, NaOH, moist AgOH. So that is as far as these two methods are concerned. So note it down, and then we are taking up some problems. I hope all the methods are clear.
Note it down.
So let us see some questions on preparation of alcohols. Here let us see this question. CH3C, CH3, CH3, CH double bond, CH2. If you see the name of this reactant, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbons in the main chain, 1, 2, 3, 3 methyl, but, 1 N. 1, 2, 3, 4, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbons in the main chain, 1, 2, 3. 3, 3, dimethyl, 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, dimethyl, but, 1 N. 3, 3, dimethyl, but, 1 N. 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, dimethyl, but, 1 N. Anyways, that is your reactant. So here you are asked to complete the reaction, and there are three reagents. First is dilute H2SO4, B2H6, H2O2, OH-, and in C it is your acetate, mercuric acetate, THF, NaBH4. See, sometimes they will not mention the complete, for example, here THF also has to come, but they sometimes will not mention the complete thing. Here dilute H2SO4 means concentrated H2SO4 plus H2O. That's why we are writing it as dilute H2SO4. So we have to understand from our practice and logic, we need to understand what type of reaction would go here. So let me do one thing. As far as B and C are concerned, or let me start with A itself. So A, let me start here. So I know basically here formation of carbocation will be there, because this reaction was undergoing formation of carbocation. CH3, double bond, CH2. And in that we are adding dilute H2SO4. So H plus will be there. And from water, what will come? Your OH minus will come. But how they will add, that is the question. So here shifting will be there. Here you will get a positive charge, here a negative charge. So if the OH comes here, basically OH comes here, and H comes here, based as per your Markovnikov's. But this carbocation is a 2 degree carbocation. We need to see, is there any probability of a 3 degree carbocation? Is there any feasibility? Yes, this methyl, if it shifts here, then you will get a carbocation here, and that 1, 2, 3, there will be a 3 degree carbocation. So here methyl shift will be there. So I write here, methyl shift. So you will get CH3C. CH3, here a positive charge, CH3, and here CH2-. Now we can attach the H plus and OH minus respectively. So here OH will come, and here H will come, so this will become CH3. You want to do the nomenclature? 1, 2, 3, 4. On 2 methyl, on 3 methyl. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbons in the main chain. 2, 3, dimethyl, but, 2, all. That is the product, 2, 3, dimethyl, but, because 4 carbons in the main chain, butane, 2, all. That is as far as this product is concerned. So option A is over. Remember, stability of carbocations. B2H6, H2O2 in presence of OH minus, you need not do any mechanism here, because the product is simple. What you have to do here is you have to take care of anti-Markovnikov's addition. So where the H and OH will add? So here more number of hydrogens are there. As per Markovnikov's, here hydrogen, but we need to reverse the order for anti-Markovnikov's, and this will be Markovnikov. So I am writing the answer for this, because this is Markovnikov's addition, and this is your anti-Markovnikov's addition. So I am writing the first result this, and then I will reverse the answer. CH3C, CH3, CH3CH. Markovnikov's means here hydrogen will come and here OH will come and here anti Markovnikov. So my result will be this CH3CH. Here hydrogen will come and here CH2OH. I hope that is very much simple. All the options are clear to you, A, B and C. So you may expect such type of problems in your competitive exams where you need to determine the exact product. So note it down and we are taking up more problems. Note it down. Okay, so let us take up another problem. Let us see this question. Give the structure of the compound X. Compound X is your C4H8, which when treated with H2O H2SO4, means basically your H2O H2SO4 acid in presence of water, gives C4H10O, which do not show optical activity. Optical isomerism, you know, chiral carbon has to be there. If one chiral carbon is there, then the compound will become optically active. So let us see what is our compound X. Now compound X, they are saying that it is C4H8. Now you know, if the alkane, as far as alkane is there, if it's a hydrocarbon, then general formula is CnH2n+2. So 4, 8 plus 10, yani this is not an alkane. If you see alkene, that is your CnH2n. So 4, 4 to 8, so obviously this is an alkene. So one thing is clear, that your compound X is an alkene. Similarly, you should know the formula for alkyne also, and that is your CnH2n-2. So this is an alkene, and in this alkene what you are doing is basically you are adding H2SO4. So that is the source of your H+ and H2O, source of your OH-, and you are getting C4H10O. So one oxygen is there, obviously it has to be a alcohol, which is your C4H10O. So now they are asking that what is your compound X, because this compound do not show optical activity. It does not show optical activity. So let us do one thing, let us try to find all the possible X. So C4, any four carbons are there, with that we need to form an alkene. So let us see what are the possibilities. So let me say X1 can be C. Let us say double bond is here, CH3, CH2, CH and CH2. Valences is taken care of. Now let us see the number of carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbons, very good, 4 carbons, and how many hydrogens, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, very good. So this may be one of the alkene, X1. Let us try one more alkene, X2. We can draw its positional isomerism. So that will become CH3, CH, double bond, CH, CH3. So that may be another type of alkene, because they are wanting the exact alkene which on treatment with this does not show optical isomerism. So what we have to do is, this compound is not showing optical isomerism. So from here we need to do the acid catalyzed hydration. Means we have to add H+ and H2O, OH-, and then we have to see that compound should be optically inactive. So let us see. And there is one more possibility, X3. And X3 can be what? X3 can be this, because 4 carbons are there, na? CH3, C, CH3, double bond, CH2. This can be one of the compounds. Observe here carefully. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbons. And 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2, 8. Yes. So there are 3 possibilities of your X. So that's why I am denoting them as X1, X2 and X3. Now let us do one thing. One by one we are going to do their hydration, acid catalyzed hydration. So when you add H+ and OH-, how it is going to add, you know, the shifting will be there. So here a negative charge will be created, here a positive charge will be created, and obviously this is a 2-degree carbocation. There is no other shifting, because there is no feasibility of formation of any 3-degree carbocation. So here positive charge is there, here negative charge is there, here OH will come, and here what will come? Hydrogen will come, H+ will come. So the compound you are going to get is this CH3, CH2, CH2, or let me write like this, CH2, sorry, CHOH, CH3, because here hydrogen will come and here OH will come. Also, you can remember your Markovnikov's addition in acid catalyzed. If there is no rearrangement, here more number of hydrogens are there. So here what will come? Hydrogen, and here OH will come. That is what is this. Now let us see this. I mean, both the sides are symmetrical only. So anywhere you can do the shifting. Let us do the shifting is here. So here a minus sign, here a plus sign. So when we add H plus and OH minus, from where this H plus will come? From the H2SO4. And from where OH minus will come? From H2O. So here you can add H and here you can add OH. So that will become CH3, CH, OH, CH2, CH3. So that is your second compound. And let us see the third one. Again H plus and OH minus. So here shifting will be there because of the plus I effects of two CH3s. So here a negative charge will come, here a small positive charge will come. Positive charge means what will be attached there? CH3, CH3, one OH will be attached, and added to that one CH3 will be there. So that is your this C4H10O. Let us see carefully. 1, 2, 3, 4, C4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. O. Same here and same here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, 10, O. Now in this 3X, X1, X2, X3, we need to identify our compound. Now we have to see this compound, this alcohol, which particular alcohol do not show optical activity. So we need to locate chiral carbon. If one chiral carbon is there, means the compound will show optical activity. It will become an optically active compound. See here carefully. This is that carbon. Attached to this chiral carbon means what? Four different groups. Attached to this carbon, one hydrogen, one OH, one methyl, one ethyl. Four different carbons are there. It means what? This is a chiral carbon. This is a chiral compound. So it will show optical activity. I am marking it by a star. So it will show optical activity, optically active compound. What about this carbon, methyl, hydrogen, OH and ethyl group? It means this will also show optical activity, because this carbon is also optically active chiral. As far as this carbon is concerned, methyl, 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 three same groups. It means it is not a chiral carbon. It means it will be optically inactive compound. If the compound is optically inactive, it will not show optical activity. So our particular methyl is, I mean alkene is this. So that is our answer. So this is our X, because we need to find that alcohol which does not show optical activity. So this is that alcohol, and the corresponding alkene is this. So that is our answer. So give the structure of the compound. So this is the answer. I hope this question is clear to you. Such type of problems are a part of your advanced. You can note it down. Let us see one more problem. This is your cyclic compound basically. This means CH3. And in this, what we are doing is basically we are doing hydroboration oxidation. And you know, from alkene, if you do hydroboration oxidation, there will be a formation of alcohol. And if you remember carefully, this addition will be how? As per anti Markovnikov's rule. That is point number one. And I gave you one more point there, that the reaction addition of H plus and OH minus will add as per syn or cis manner. The addition is will be as per syn or cis manner. So H plus and OH minus has to come. Now if you see carefully here, to this carbon one methyl is there, and one this group is there, and double bond is there. So no hydrogens are there. To this carbon, this bond is there, this bond is there, third, and one hydrogen is there. And this carbon is having more number of hydrogens. So more number of hydrogens, that it means here hydrogen will come as per Markovnikov's, but what we are using anti-Markovnikov's. It means here what will come? OH will come and hydrogen will go there. So our product would be this. Here OH will come. That is point number one. As I told you, addition will be as per cis manner or syn manner. Syn and cis meaning is same only. Syn anti, cis trans. Cis, two bulky groups on the same side, and trans, two bulky groups on the opposite side, and syn, two bulky groups on the same side, anti, two bulky groups on the opposite side. So that is as far as I can write here. Cis, anti, syn, I mean cis trans and syn anti. This is the meaning. So as I am saying that the addition of H and OH will be in the syn manner, means H and OH will come and add in the same side. H and O product will not be syn. The addition of H and OH will be in the syn manner or cis manner. It means that if OH is adding like this, then H will also add like this, then automatically this CH3, this will move here, and one more hydrogen will also move here, and the final product would become a trans product. This will be a trans product. Why? Why? Because addition of H and OH will be in the syn manner or cis manner. So H and OH will add in the same manner, in the same side. So OH and H are in the same side. But if you see the final product here, this is the bulky group and this is the bulky group. They are on opposite side. So this will be a trans. Here geometrical isomerism is there, na? Because this bond is not free to rotate. I told you, in aliphatic chains, you have to see the double bond. Along that, geometrical isomerism will be there. And as far as cyclic compounds are there, if I mean your cyclic compound is there, then there also geometrical isomerism will be there. So this is a trans product. So I hope all the two methods, one is from haloalkanes, that is by hydrolysis, KOH, NaOH, aqueous, moist AgOH or moist Ag2O, preparation of alcohols as per SN1, SN2, sometimes elimination product may also be there. That's why it's not a very useful method. And then from alkanes, acid catalyzed hydration, hydroboration oxidation, antimonic oxidation, and mercuration and demercuration in presence of mercuric acetate, THF, and finally demercuration with a reducing agent. Demercuration means removing of mercuric acetate. So that was basically your preparation of alcohols, and we have taken up some problems also. So that's it as far as this class is concerned. We'll meet in the next session with three more preparation methods. Totally five methods I told you, I promised you. Two already we have seen. We are going to see three more methods. One is reduction, second method will be from Grignard reagent, and third method will be from primary amines. So keep on waiting for the videos.